Okay, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'm going to show you how to make a movie from Abacus. I'm using Abacus 2017. So first, to make a movie, you need something that you can animate into Abacus. And what I have here is a column made out of composite materials that is subject to axial load, and it will buckle. And the analysis has been done using the RIGS method, nonlinear analysis. And it took 64 frames and an arc length of it's not time, it's not a function of time, it's a function of sort of load, which is the arc length. And in 64 frames, it got to 4 times 10 to the 6 length for that arc length. So I cannot use that as a time. So I'm gonna have to do the movie in terms of frames. Frames are 64, so it's very reasonable. All right, so if I go to the last frame, you see the column is buckled there. We'll see better later in the movie. And if I go to the first increment, that is the unloaded column, which shows in green, with no deformation. Okay? So the first thing you gotta do is you have to set up the movie with animation options. And so you click here, and that's gonna bring this window. And in this window, I'm gonna choose player, play once, so the movie is not very long. With the loop, for example, we'll make a long movie. All right, and frame rate, I'm gonna pick slow so that I have time to see what's going on. All right, because I only have 64. Then half cycle, I only want to load the beam until it deforms completely. I don't want it to go back. And also, if I make full cycle, it will be twice as long. Then time history, I'm gonna pick frame based because those are 64, and not time based because that will be 10 to the 6 seconds. It's too long. Here there is nothing I have to do, and viewports, I'm going to select the viewport where the simulation is, which is that one, and that's it. That's the setup. Once it is set up, then we go to animate, and in animate you got to make sure you have check mark time history. All right, even though it's not time, it's arc length, but it's going to show us time history. All right, and so once time history is checked, then we have to make sure that we have everything we need to show. And one of the things I want to show is I want to show contour plots of U2. U2 is UY, the vertical deflection. The horizontal deflection UX is easy to see, as you have seen already when the beam deflects in an Euler mode, lateral mode. But the vertical is not so easy to see, so I will illustrate with a contour plot of U2, which is the vertical deflection, and you will clearly see the colors. And then you understand what's going on. You see, the lateral, the Euler mode, is easy to see because the beam actually moves. But the vertical is not so easy to see, so we will illustrate with contour plots. So I reset to the origin, the load equal to zero. I say OK here, so you see it's there. Then animate, I'm gonna put the time history. All right, and then next, animate again. All right, and then time history, make sure that's check marked. And then we go save as, and that brings another window. And in this window, you pick the file name, pick whatever name you want. Then format, I use QuickTime because AVI crashed my computer. Okay, and then for the viewports, the viewports I want to pick just in case current viewport. All right, and then the rate, I'm going to pick a low rate, and you have to play with this. You have to make several movies until you like it. I'm going to use a low rate so that the movie will be slow. I only have 64 frames, and so I can see what's going on. The viewers later will be able to see what's going on. And once I have all that, then once I hit OK, the animation will start to play and the movie will start to be recorded. It's not being recorded yet until I click OK here. So I click OK, says override, yes. Okay, now the animation starts, and it's only 64 frames, so it goes very fast, and then it's done. All right. Okay, so now it's done, the movie is done. I go look for it, and yeah, here is File Explorer. There's the movie, MOV, that's QuickTime, 8.7 megabytes, not so big. Then double click here and bring the player, and I'm using AVS Player, and here's the player, and the movie is already playing, you see? But you don't see anything, but because the column is not buckling at the beginning, this is normal. Under service condition, the column doesn't buckle. Then when the column has a lot of load, then we'll start to buckle to the side in an Euler mode, combined with a local mode that you can see with the colors of the contour plots. And that's it, the movie is done. All right. And once the movie is done, then we can go find it, and that's it.